Well, hi there, everyone. I'm here in Fort Erie on my first day after my move. I'm loaded with boxes in the house, but I would be remiss if I didn't get out to take in the total solar eclipse. It's about 3:15 in the afternoon right now on April 8th, 2024, and in about 5 minutes, it's going to be the moon completely blocking the sun. And I'm standing with Lake Erie behind me, and it's getting dark, very dark. And Erie is a good name for this place right now, no pun intended. And the last time this happened here was in 1925, and as I understand from the Town of Fort Erie website, the next time this happens where we're able to see it here, a total solar eclipse, is not until October 26th, 2144. I know I'll be gone by then, but Mr. B's music will still be going. I don't know whether he saw one. As far as I could tell, Bach was not alive during a time at which a total solar eclipse was available in Germany. Oh, look how dark it's getting. Isn't this crazy? Ooh. But this makes me, of course, this makes us aware of the galaxy, the cosmos, and these are all images that come to my mind when I'm playing Bach's music, because it's so transcendental. It's almost a state of ecstasy when you're playing his music. And he was very much interested in the stars and mathematics and all of these things. He was such a learned musician. And I can only imagine what he might have experienced, might have been feeling, were he to see something like this. His Art of Fugue, you know, the last piece of music he wrote, the cycle of 14 contrapunti and 4 canons, all based on one subject, that is very much based on Pythagoras and the idea that all things come from one. And look at this. Ah, this is incredible. 1925 here in Niagara was the last time that this happened. 99 years ago, 1925. It's almost to you on the camera, it's pitch dark. In real life here, it's almost pitch dark. Let me do a quick scan around. I don't know if you can't see anything. The bridge is behind, to my side, the Peace Bridge connecting the USA and Canada, Buffalo, New York. Those lights you see, that's Buffalo. Wow. This is very emotional. We'll be dead when this happens again. And in a few minutes, it's going to be daylight. Isn't that great? And there's just enough light here that I can see my notes. the sun's corona, which I can't see because I don't have glasses, sadly. I just moved here and I didn't get a chance. There wasn't enough time to get to the place for the glasses, but that's okay. But that sun's corona, which we'll be seeing pictures of later all over the news, I'm sure, that will be visible for 3 to 5 minutes. And Fort Erie, this town here, is in the direct path of all of this. This is one of the best places in Canada, if not the best place in Canada to see this. Oh, and the sky around me is kind of a bad bruise, kind of purpley pinky. You can't see anything. Oh my gosh. Let me turn around and get some more of that skyline. You know, there's Buffalo, those lights. It's like nighttime, right? Holy moly. This really is something. This really is something. Again, from the Town of Fort Erie website, it says, Fort Erie gets the longest duration of this eclipse seen anywhere in Canada. You barely need to even leave home to see it if you live here. And as I say, the next time this happens here is October 26th, 2144. So my clock has been running here about 5 minutes. Wow. And it's still dark. I'll have to put some chapters on this video, a timestamp, so you can check in when this is over. Ah, I'm just gonna let it run. You know, I thought about, where did I want to be when this happened? Did I want to be in my house at my piano? Or did I want to be here in the water? It was a bit of a tough decision. But I decided to be outside by the water to experience this. And I'm glad I did. But I was thinking about what I would play on the piano if I were at my piano right now. And I think it would be the first contrapuntis from Art of Fugue. It would be a fugue. Isn't that funny? Let me know in the comments what piece of Bach you would play for these 4 minutes or so of the eclipse. Fugue definitely comes to mind. Italian concerto? No, not by a long shot. I would never play that. Or an invention? Maybe. But a fugue. Maybe the E major one, but I'm thinking a C sharp minor fugue. Oh my gosh, and now it's lightening up. Look at this, you're gonna see me again soon. This is incredible. Oh my gosh. I gotta make sure I look okay here, that I'm not crying again. This is like, I should rename my channel. Performing, exploring, and crying through the music of Bach. Ah, can you see me? I haven't moved. Oh, we're a part of a bigger picture. Oh. Yep, Lake Erie behind me. There's Buffalo. Let's do a little pan. Oh, that was incredible. That was absolutely incredible. Now it feels like early morning. And behind me are the customs, if you're crossing the bridge. And blue skies resume. My goodness, eh? Let's just walk a little bit. Ah, I grant you, it would have been nice to have the glasses to look up there. But what was more of a turn-on for me was just taking in the shadow of the darkness. There was a lot of people back there laying on lawn chairs, on their backs, as though they were getting a suntan, but the opposite. No suntan today. Oh, this is such a lovely place to come. Even before I moved out this way, I would often come here for just for a ride and to walk along the water. It's a very historic area. The War of 1812, lots of old houses and the indigenous people and the history of it all, and with the Americans right over there, a stone's throw away. What a way to welcome in my new home. My move of 2024, which was so unexpected and shocking. Because as you know, my landlord gave me notice that I had to go because he wanted to sell the place. What a time it's been. But I did sleep well last night, and looking forward to getting back there and trying out the piano and unpacking a few boxes. I don't have internet, so that'll be another day or two, but we're getting there. And let's just get one more shot of the water here. Oh, I think I'm going to be dreaming about that for a while. But seriously, if you let me know in the comments, what piece of music of Bach's would you associate or want to play during an eclipse like that? But I do want to thank you. Before I wrap this up, I really want to thank those of you who left me your comments after my last video. And I was reluctant to put that one up because, well, I look terrible. I don't look much better now, but and the place was a mess and the footage was shaky. But there's something to be said, I think, for realness. And that was definitely real. We have been suffering in there, a lot of stress lately. So I wanted to share that with you, and you know I feel badly for not getting videos up on the channel lately because of all this moving drama. And that will change soon, but still a few more weeks before I can get my bearings and get my lights, camera, action, everything set up. Okay, unpack some food in a pot and a pan or two. That would be nice. But seriously, thank you for your nice comments and for sticking around on my channel. And I wish you well. And again, it won't be too long before we're back to exploring the music of Mr. B with performances and practice tips and shenanigans from my piano workstation and my tinkering with Bach. I've got some ideas there. So stay tuned. And sun is out nice and brightly. Yeah, so be well, happy practicing, and we'll see you again soon. Okay? Bye-bye.